Here are 5 niche mistakes that you can avoid when choosing a niche for your freelancing business. Hey everyone, John Limuel Humawid here. I make videos about freelancing, video editing, and video strategy. Subscribe if that sounds interesting to you. And make sure to hit that notification bell. That way, you never miss an episode. In this video, we're talking about 5 niche mistakes that you want to avoid when you're choosing your niche. Now, I can't stress enough how important it is to choose a niche with your freelancing business. Now, I've already discussed a little about this in my previous videos. So basically, in summary, instead of choosing a high-paying skill, the first thing that you should do is to choose a niche or a market. Now, I could go on and on about how important that step is, but for the purposes of this video, let me summarize it in just one sentence. Your marketing is more powerful, conversations more meaningful, and it's much easier to get clients when you know exactly who you should be talking to. And so in order to be really successful with your freelancing business, we have to choose a market or a niche to serve. And hopefully by the end of this video, you'll avoid these 5 mistakes so you can take your freelancing business to the next level. Okay, so here are 5 niche mistakes that you should avoid when you're choosing a niche. Number one is thinking that you're marrying your choice of niche for the rest of your life. One thing that's holding freelancers back when choosing a niche is that they think once they choose a niche, that's final, that's it for the rest of your life, and you can't change it. Of course you can change it. But what's important in this stage is that you choose or you pick a niche. Second niche mistake, don't fall victim to not being able to decide and being torn between multiple things. Everyone can come up with 4 or 5 ideas for a niche, and there's no reason why you can't pick one out of those 4 or 5. It doesn't matter if you get it wrong because you can always change it later, but you need to pick something to start. Third niche mistake is feeling like you have nothing to give or you have no ability to create value. At this stage of choosing a niche, don't even think about whether you can help that niche or not. Don't think about what you can offer to that niche. Don't think, how can I help them? How can I create value for this niche? How can I make money from this niche? If you're doing this, you're already thinking too far ahead, but at this stage, all we really need to do is to choose a niche. There's absolutely nothing else to think of. Just pick one. Fourth niche mistake is copying what other people are doing or what they have done instead of owning this decision yourself. So a lot of people, when they can't make a decision for themselves, they usually offload that decision to someone else to relieve the pressure. They'll be like, hey, do you have any suggestions for your niche? Or, hey, that person is doing well on his or her niche. Maybe that's something that I can do. What is a good niche? What is the most high-paying niche? Freelancers get stuck on this stage because they think that there's this one niche that's the best of the best, but there isn't. The grass isn't greener on the other side. The grass is greener where you water it, and that's the same when you pick a niche. It doesn't matter what niche you pick, you yourself can create opportunity in that niche. Don't think that you have to copy what other people are doing. Don't look at what other people are doing in different places. Don't look at what other people are doing in their Facebook groups. Own this decision yourself. If you want to become a serious businessman or a freelancer or an entrepreneur, now is the time to start taking some responsibility and owning some decisions yourself. Fifth niche mistake is being too afraid to be you and to do what you know you want to do just to conform or fit in. A lot of times, people already know what they want to do. They know what niche they want to choose. But for some reason, they don't do that. They pick something else just because they want to conform and fit in with everyone. Maybe you're someone who wants to help the health and fitness niche, but because you see everyone doing FB ads or digital marketing, you end up doing that as well. If you really want to be happy and successful in your own freelancing business, you're not going to do what everybody else is doing. You're going to do your own research, you're going to think for yourself, and you're going to own your decision of choosing that niche. Seriously, it doesn't really matter if you choose the wrong niche or not. It happened to me. I know because the first niche I chose was digital marketers or digital marketing agencies, and my offer to them was video editing. And as I was reaching out to them and connecting with them, I realized that video editing isn't a priority for them. It's not something that they absolutely need for their business. What digital marketers or digital agencies need are results for their clients through their ads. And that, yes, they can do that with video, but it's not a high priority. Even though I chose a wrong niche, I was still able to learn from the process. I was still able to get used to rejections. I was able to get used to putting myself out there and reaching out to people, reaching out to strangers and connecting with them. So don't worry if you choose a wrong niche, or maybe you're in a niche that it doesn't feel right at first. That's okay, because during that process, you will learn more about yourself. You will learn about reaching out to people. You will learn how to deal with rejections. All of these things you can do when you choose your next niche. So now that you know the 5 niche mistakes that you can avoid when you're choosing your niche, let's do some quick exercises on how to actually choose a niche. So I'm gonna give you 2 exercises to give you an idea of what niche you can possibly choose. First exercise, list down 5 things you're good at. Now, it doesn't have to be business related. It doesn't have to be something that's focused on making money. Just write down 5 things that you're good at. Now, most people don't even sit down and think about what they're good at. So take action right now. List down 5 things that you think you're good at. Second exercise, ask 5 to 10 people what they think your weaknesses and strengths are. Now, in the description box below, I'm gonna leave a link to an email template that you can send 5 to 10 people of your close friends or family and ask them what they think your strengths and weaknesses are. So the reason we want to do this is because we often can't identify our own strengths because we tend to undervalue them or take them for granted. So we need to get out of our own head and see what other people think our strengths and weaknesses are. So just follow the email template that I'll leave in the description box below. Basically, you're just telling them that you're going through this training and that in this training, you're asked to identify your own strengths and weaknesses and ask other people what they think as well. And basically, you're just gonna ask them 3 questions. Number 1, what are my strengths? What can you count on me for? Number 2, what are my weaknesses? What can you not count on me for? And third set of questions, what is my unique ability? What is it that I'm the best at in the world? Seriously, just these 2 exercises will give you a clearer image of who you are as a person, and then we can eventually translate that to becoming a freelancer. So for now, just follow those 2 exercises. And on the next video, we're gonna talk about how to choose a niche or a market. Don't let the decision of choosing a niche stop you. And hopefully these 5 niche mistakes will help you make that decision. Thanks again, guys, for watching. I hope you got a lot of value out of this video. Please comment down below on your single biggest takeaway. Please do give us a thumbs up and subscribe. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of our future videos. Until next time, guys, peace.